Oh, right. This is Umbrella Reviews with the Circus Voices team at Edinburgh Festival Fringe. We have just come out of Image Selfie with Eggs, which is a one-woman, one-hour-long hand-balancing show with Natalie Reckert. But it's more than that, so we are going to pass it around and show our initial responses coming straight out. Who's going to stick their hand up? Nobody. Reckert. Right, okay.
So I was refreshingly surprised by this show. I've seen a lot of lecture demonstration type pieces, and this one fits very well into that oeuvre. But there were a few moments, particularly in the first half, I think, that could really do with developing or taking out. There's a lot of repetition, especially in the dance vocabulary, that I feel can be pushed a lot further. And just didn't stand up to the rest of the work that was really, really strong. The bit that moved me the most was just the sheer beauty of it, and she just made such a beautiful vision at the end with the purple, literal purple rain. So those single moments win me over for those weaker moments at the beginning that I was really, I had written quite critical notes about. And also that makes it really strong is her awareness of what it is. Like, yeah, I like to do handstands and that makes me feel special, and that taps into the notion of the performer and the acrobat and the circus performer and what that actually means to embody that. So some interesting concepts and some little critiques to work on. So that was a really enjoyable show for me to watch and think about.
Cool.
Hello.
Hello.
I also really liked it because I don't really even know why. I'm still in a bit of shock of coming out of seeing a one-hour handstand show. I thought I was going to hate it, I'm going to be honest. Like, I was just prepared to not have a lot of fun. But then she was really engaging, and like a lot of what she said I thought really spoke about performers, but especially circus performers. A lot of that feeling special or being invincible, and pushing things to a limit that you physically like can't go any further, and like doing that to yourself. And she's also really good at what she does, so it was a sort of like made it easy to watch because she was so good at it. It was maybe a little long, some bits of it, so I sort of like started to drift off, but then she would bring you back in by talking a little bit. And yeah, I really definitely liked the ending because it was very like visual and pretty nice. Which I think is quite hard with handstanding to make it such a big impact from the audience, so that was good.
So it's the 8th of August. As you can see, it's a beautiful summer day in Edinburgh. And we've just seen the show of Natalie Reckert. And in Spanish, you would say rara como un perro verde. She's as special as a green dog. So I think that defines her as a performer. She's got very high skill technique, but she doesn't have to brag about them, and she's interested in exploring other things. If you are interested in other types of shows, this is an interesting piece of work. Obviously, then, I still think some things can be improved structure-wise. But she's for sure an interesting performer.
This has been my least favourite out of everything that we've seen. And everybody's literally turned around at me and been like, what? yeah, again, I think I wanted to reiterate what everyone else has said. She's obviously an incredibly powerful performer and acrobat. And she has these nice little stories about explaining, like, what she, I think the message she's trying to get across is how it feels to perform, which is a great subject for a show. But then I just felt like everything else that she did didn't relate to that or demonstrate that in any way. It just kind of felt strange. I didn't understand the symbolism of the eggs. I didn't understand why she was cracking them, and then a lot of the time I felt the dancing, she's such an incredible acrobat, the dancing feels kind of amateur in comparison. And there was pumpy music and it was kind of upbeat, but I didn't really understand it, I think. And there we go.
See if I can get that back on me again, because there's some light, I can't really see, I'll just squint at it. This for me was the most exciting thing I've seen so far. So I was wondering, and I actually got a bit emotional at the end by how special it was. And the show is constructed in a way that kind of gives you a tongue-in-cheek nod at a deliberately cathartic feel-good ending that is designed to give you those kind of emotions, and it does that very knowingly, which I enjoy, but there was something else behind that as well. Expectations are a weird thing, because quite often if you go into something with low expectations, you'll come out enjoying it more. If you go into something with high expectations, there's more of a chance that you might get disappointed. But I've been looking forward to this show for a year and a half, and it was better than I thought. Normally I do find hand balancing kind of boring, but she delighted me again and again. I think it brings up the magic and the mechanics of what circus can be and is simultaneously to people in the one show. And okay, yes, I will agree there are some points where it could probably cut down. I think maybe there is one section where I wrote, this was probably a little more than was necessary, but that's a really minor niggle, and this is really interesting work, and I will say more about it when I've got more time and space. And any final thoughts? Final thoughts? No, they're all chatting in the doorway. Okay, and that was the last show that we're seeing as a team. So that was the end of our post-show responses. If you've enjoyed them, leave some comments, tell us we should do more, tell us never do this again, it's a horrible idea. I don't know, let us know. And keep tuned to this space for the other work that's coming out of the Circus Voices project. Cheers! Bye!